Hello there, everyone. My name is Oversoul. This is Oversoul Gaming, and welcome back to Let's Replay Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep. Now, I apologize in the last couple of episodes if I sounded, like, quieter and less enthusiastic. It's because it was, like, 3 in the morning, I was trying to be quiet, and I was also tired as shit, so it's like, that was, like, the last 3 episodes, maybe? But, yeah. Anyways, also, I hurt myself. Oh, God, ouch. Okay, let me explain. So, let's land here in Neverland while I explain, let this loading screen go. Anyways, outside, it's icy as shit because it's, like, raining, and then the rain freezes, but then during the day it melts, so then it's, like, all water, but then the water freezes, and at night, and it's just a mess. So, like, during the day, it's, like, a mixture of ice and water, and the sidewalks and shit are all, like, wet, so it all looks the same, because the ice is thin. So, I hurt myself. Look at that! Hold on a second. What in the fuck? Hold on, I totally forgot about that. They went out of their way this time to show you Tinkerbell's underwear. I swear to God they did. What in the hell? Like, she normally has a short skirt, but that time it was just, like, extra short. And if you don't believe me, go back and look again, you dirty perverts. You know you're going to. Now that I said something. And you're gonna feel guilty about it, too. But, anyways. Shit, now I lost my train of thought. Thanks, Disney! You dirty, dirty fucks. Mickey liked it! He was like, that ass, though! Move it. Fucking Vanitas is here! Oh god, it's a whole smorgasbord! Why? Why Neverland? Why did everyone choose Neverland to crash the party? Like, they all might as well get together and do drugs. I swear. It's basically what's going on here. Will you stop with the upskirts? Fuck.
Name's Ventus. But everybody just calls me Vent.
Who's your daddy?
Guess when I sat down to rest, I must have fallen asleep.
Sat down to rest? What did you just...
But where'd you come from?
Well, you see...
When two parents, when a mommy and daddy love each other very much...
All right, we're going!
Tinkerbell's like, you can't hear this, you're too young.
Come on, Ben!
You can't hear this, you're too young!
Where are you guys off to?
Come stare at my underwear some more.
Pink saw a shooting star, and we're gonna go hunt it down!
There's that shooting star again!
Mind if I come along?
Of course not! But you gotta agree to follow us!
Yeah, it's, right over... That away by the Indian camp.
Ready, men? Forward, march.
Okay.
Okay. All right. That's how most of my friends answer text. I'll send people this like long, elaborate, like 5-page text, like you know, telling them all kinds of cool shit and everything, and then they'll just respond with okay. Well, like, all right, fuck you too, asshole.
Yeah.
Anyways, back to my story of me hurting myself. So I slipped and fell outside, as you can imagine, because ice and such. And I, sorry, I'm thinking back on the perfect timing of Mickey going, Oh, I can't get over that. Oh, that just couldn't have been better placed. Okay, anyways, I promise I will try to finish my story. I know, this right here, this shit, I know this is why you guys watch this, because of moments like these. And I just gotta say, I love you all so much. You're helping me grow! Grow strong! I'm a big boy now. Not really. I'm not quite there, but, you know. Hey, yeah, bun cuckoo falca! Oh yeah. Feel the burn, bitches. So, anyways, after I fell and hurt myself, my wrists have been hurting all day. It took me forever to tell you that my wrists hurt, basically is the premise of the story. My wrists have been hurting, like, really bad. Well, not that super bad, but just, you know, whenever I go to use them, which is, you know, typically a lot throughout the day. So, anyways, basically whenever I go to turn the doorknob or, like, lift something heavy, or if I put pressure on my wrists a certain way, they just hurt. So I think I might have maybe sprained them, but I just can't be fucked to go to the hospital right now because I have to do this. I need my arms! I need my arms to do my job, shit. And to do stuff around the house, because it's also my job to keep the fucking place clean! On top of me doing the YouTubes. So, I mean, it's fair after all. The fiance, she's a social worker. Went to college for it and everything. You know, because no one told her that she couldn't. Yeah! Fuck you, Sticker! I will have you by the end of the day. Or by the end, like, right now. Check this. No! Fuck, I'll come back when I have Glide, and then we'll see who's the wise ass. Fuck you, you laughing at me, bitch? Eat a dick. I mean, I guess it wouldn't be too bad if I didn't have the use of my hands, because let's be honest, this is Kingdom Hearts, and I am nothing if not a walking, talking Kingdom Hearts encyclopedia. I could play this game with my feet. Fuck, I could play this game with my dick. That's how goddamn talented I am. Yeah. Anyways, welcome back to Oversoul Gaming. The place where we ruin your childhood one episode of Kingdom Hearts at a time. You know, now that I think about it, the Lost Boys from Peter Pan, they were furries before furries were a thing, if you really think about it. And the fact that it's just a bunch of young boys, you know, and Peter Pan, it's a little disturbing. All I can say is somebody's having a little too much fun playing dress up on Neverland Ranch, if you know what I mean. Okay. Alright. Maybe we'll back down for a bit. Let's make it more subtle, shall we? Fuck, I missed it. As for you, bitch, you will also feel the fury of my gliding ability once it has returned. And where the hell am I supposed to go? I forget. I can't remember if I'm supposed to go... Eat a pineapple! Oh, wait a minute, I think the shooting star is at the Indian camp. Peter Pan was a very racist movie with the way they treated the Native Americans. Old school Disney. It's a classic, but it's also classically racist. Can't get around it. I love that Kingdom Hearts... Fuck! Note to self, stop using Sonic Blade next to water cliff. Water cliff thing. Drop off thing. Stop doing it. All together, just don't. Miaba! There. That fixes it all. Anyways, I was gonna say, I love that so far it seems like Kingdom Hearts 3 is going to be adding mostly, brand new worlds, and a lot of them are based on more recent Disney movies. So we've got Tangled and Big Hero 6 are both confirmed. And, oh man, I would just love to, I would love it, I would absolutely love it if they put a Zootopia world in there, oh my god. Because I was like one of my favorite Disney movies as of recent. I thought they were kind of going a little bit downhill there for a while when they were getting near the end of their 2D animation, but then they really brought it up. Recently, like, they're making kind of a, like, ever since Frozen, which I'm not afraid to admit I liked. I know it's overhyped, but whatever. Ever since that, I feel like they've been on a roll. And their live-action remakes are fantastic, too. Like, the Jungle Book was a shot-for-shot true to the original. It was awesome. You know, in the original stories, Peter Pan's actually a bad guy. If you've ever seen Once Upon a Time, the TV show, they treat him as such.
Real pirate treasure?
Sure! Well, guess who caught sight of Hook right when he was stashing his treasure? What do you say we sneak in?
And Hook's a good guy, that's what's funny about it.
Let's go!
In the show, anyways. He's kind of a bad guy turned good. Peter Pan and Hook were both villains, but they were villains that hated each other.
Tinkerbell, what's gotten into you?
We were all supposed to go hunt for a shooting star together.
Forget that. Pirate treasure is way more fun.
Peter Pan said, fuck your plans. We're doing what I want, bitch. You know why? Because I'm Peter motherfucking goddamn Pan, bitch!
Come on,
I run this shit!
You're a better sport than her, right?
And if you don't do what I say, I'll spank you. Ventus said, alright, fuck you too then, bitch! And Peter was so dumbfounded, he was like, how dare you not do what I want to do? Then said, yeah, thanks, but no thanks. Peace out, bitch. If you're not gonna go with me to look for the shooting star, I'm just gonna go by myself. I don't give a fuck about what you're doing. Pirate treasure. Do I look like I give a fuck about pirates? Who do you think I am, Sora? Bitch, I'm not pansy-ass little Sora. I'm motherfucking Ventus. I've been places. I've seen shit. I've seen stuff that would make Sora piss his little panties. Okay. Now, Riku, that's a true hood fucker. That's a true hood motherfucker right there. Riku knows. Riku's from the ghetto. He gets it. Alright. Where am I going with this? I don't know. All I know is I'm gonna ransack Pan's place because he was a dick. I'm taking your shit, bitch. Because RPGs. Do something about it. Motherfucker! Alright, well that takes care of that. It's gonna be a while before that Experience Walker ability really, gets us somewhere again. 424 more steps, but it'll be faster than that because, because of the Unverse that we'll kill in the process, helping us level up, obviously. Wonder if I should edit my command deck yet. Let's see where I'm going. Nope, Mega Flare's still not quite there. Tornado Strike, though. Alright, let's see what I want to replace Tornado Strike with. Let's go with... I had Faith equipped at one point. Did I fully level it up? Faith is good for healing yourself. I did level it up. Okay. Let's equip Salvation then, because I have Kiraga. That'll be good for now. Where is it? Where'd it go? Oh, yeah. Salvation. This is... Oh, yeah, I need to level... that one has an ability attached to it. Salvation is basically the, ability that Roxas uses in the boss battle against him in the final mixed version of Kingdom Hearts 2. Found the Indian camp. Of course, I knew where it was the whole time. Duh. Holy shit, biscuits. Oh, Tink came with me. I forgot about that.
Mickey's Star Shard?
Yep. Don't flirt with me, Tink. You're too small, and also probably too young.
And a pixie. Must be me birthday.
Do you remember in Terra's story when Captain Hook came back and he had Tinkerbell captured?
One of Peter Pan's brats.
This is how he got him. Or her.
Sparrow, if he wants his precious Tinkerbell back, he'd best meet me at Mermaid Lagoon.
Stop! Scram!
And see, the reason Ventus couldn't save her is obviously because the Inverse show up and make things difficult. Obviously. I think I might have mentioned this before, but just in case I didn't, the Unversed, obviously, are negative emotions given form. But if you pay attention, obviously, they appear whenever someone's negative emotions are at their strongest. And it's not always one of the main characters, sometimes it's the villains. A lot of the boss Unversed appear because of... like when we were playing as Terra, the Symphony Master appeared because of Lady Tremaine's jealousy of Cinderella, for example. Anyways. So basically right now, Terra... So you saw when Pan and the other two left, to go find the pirate treasure, and then Ven came this way. So Ven and Terra are actually here at the same time, as you can assume, based off of the information we're given. Wow. That finished it. So basically, well, when they split up from Ven, that was when they go meet Terra at the cave, and Terra and Peter Pan fight. And Pan's like, you've been tricked. And then that's when Captain Hook captures Tinkerbell, and then he shows up in the cave with Tinkerbell, and then Terra lets her loose.
Ever wonder what stars are? Where light comes from?
there we go again with that. What are stars even? Fucking magnets, how do they work? Another dated reference.
Can you feel the love tonight?
Look out below!
Peter, help! Tinkerbell's been pixie-napped.
Then I'm too late. Hook's gonna pay for this.
I'm gonna shake him in the booty again.
In the Mermaid Lagoon.
Gotta be an ambush. That old codfish thinks he's clever.
That old codfish.
Hey, I'm going too.
Well, we have to hurry. Can you keep up?
Nope.
You bet.
Because I can't fucking fly. But alright then. Sure, don't sprinkle. Oh, that's right. Tinkerbell's been kidnapped. Never mind. I was gonna say, don't sprinkle none of the pixie dust on me, you know, could help. But then I was like, oh shit, the whole thing that you need is what we're going after. Excuse me for my stupidity. That was my bad. Hey, it's a long windup, but as you can tell, it's fucking worth it.
Gotcha!
Anybody else? Y'all wanna play? No? Alright then. Peace. I'm going to the Mermaid Lagoon. And this is when we start getting shot at.
Peter Pan ahoy! Land the long time and fire!
So from now on, whenever we come to this world, there'll be cannonballs going off. Because of this shit right here. In this area, though. This area and the next one over.
Where's it coming from?
On the water!
The pirate ship, obviously. Like, literally the only pirate ship out there. Hey, where'd the cannons coming from? Couldn't possibly be that one lone pirate ship in the middle of the fucking ocean. Or sea, or whatever.
Tink, it's
Good
you!
God.
And you're all right! What? A strange fellow with a funny-looking sword has...
That would be Terra.
Hold on! I gotta stop that.
That's after Terra let Tinkerbell
okay,
free.
I'll go after Hook.
Right. Tink, if you would.
There we go. Ventus is...
What?
It's pixie dust. Bet you feel lighter now, don't ya?
That's an allegory for drugs if I've ever heard one. It's weed, man. I bet you feel all floaty now, don't ya, bro? It's cocaine, man. I bet you feel all energized now, don't ya? It's meth, man. I bet you feel all toothless now, don't ya? It's heroin, man. I bet you feel all homeless now, don't ya? Okay, I'm done. And let's equip it. Equip it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Sure, I guess we never had anything equipped there. Oh, must have been the original block. We have renewal block. I'm always gonna get renewal block because fuck yeah, if you can block and heal at the same time, how is that not an advantage? Tell me. Eh.
Whee!
Oh, by the way, Glide, it's really slow as shit right now, but as it levels up, it'll get faster. So. Now that's how you do it, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Yeah. Of course, it stands to reason that the only reason, or that Ventus is the only one who gets Glide because Sora. Same reason Roxas got a chance to do it. I guess I shouldn't question the fact that, you know, I questioned in one episode why Hercules doesn't mention to Sora and the crew later about Terra, Ventus, and Aqua, you know, meeting them during his teenage years. And then I realized, well, nobody tells them about about meeting fucking Roxas and Shion in 358 Days Over 2. So if you only saw the movie version of it, then you wouldn't know what I'm talking about. But like in the actual like DS game, there was a lot of extra cutscenes in the Disney World, so they cut out of the movie version, that where Roxas and Shion had interactions with people like the genie and Tinkerbell. Tinkerbell gave Roxas and Axel the ability to fly for a while in Neverland. So, yeah. God, I love that! So cool. I should have Ars Arcanum somewhere. I need to equip that here eventually, too. Let's take off Mega Flare and equip Ars Arcanum. I think Mega Flare's leveled up fully, right? Because Ars Arcanum will come in handy with this upcoming boss battle. Whee! Glide. Such a useful ability. I never tire of it! Oh, shit. Hold on. I done fuckulated myself there. Didn't jump at the right time. Okay, there we go. This is more like it, yeah? Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, my thing wasn't full? Damn, that sucks. Alright, cool. That settles that. Back to the cliff path. Oh yeah, treasure raid. I forgot about that. Oh shit. That's Wingblade. Oh, let's see if I can go find someone to use this on. You have got to see this. Look at how cool it is. Oh god, yes. I'm not gonna get it full, but still, look at it. You've got, like, blades that are wings, or wings that are blades, hence the name Wingblade. I mean, look at it! Motherfucking look at it, it's so cool! Okay. Sorry, I'm a sucker for awesome-looking shit like that. Time for a bossicle battling. Bet you can't guess who we're gonna fight. Yep.
Alas, and so passeth a worthy opponent.
Really?
That his would be such an inglorious.
You think just because the cannon fire stopped that he's dead? Don't be a fool.
At last, that scurvy brat will never trouble me again.
I wouldn't be so sure that, Hook.
Hey, that's Pan's line. Although it does sound good on you.
Tell me.
But of course.
Oh, Jimmy. Lost that Peter Pan.
Oh, you want to go?
Oh, that sound.
He's like, I'm pissed at Peter Pan, so I'm gonna take it out on you, because you're the next best thing.
Stay away from me!
I don't think so.
You're not gonna mess with the Keyblade wielder. You know, I have to wonder, because we're about to kick Captain Hook's ass. After getting his ass handed to him once by a Keyblade wielder, you have to wonder how in the hell Maleficent was able to recruit him to her cause. After knowing that there was a Keyblade wielder involved. Like, wouldn't you learn, if you get your ass kicked once, what makes you think you're not gonna get your ass kicked again? How did you escape that? That was clearly meant to hurt the fuck out of you.
I'll get you for this! You only walk in the black.
Okay, that was... What the fuck? I was blocking, and it didn't even do, like, the ching from blocking, because I'm so short that his shit was just going over my head anyways. Seems kind of counterproductive, doesn't it, Hook? Damn! What a way to finish him. Jesus. Slow down, Ven. You're gonna give the old codger a broken hip. Fuck. Oh. Nice gagging noise. He said, This goofy shit, I swear. It's always nice to be able to laugh at stupid shit like that in the middle of this otherwise extremely depressing story. We need comic relief like that. Considering the sadness of most of this franchise in general.
Chest I told you about. We snatched it right from Hook's hiding place. Huh? How come it's empty?
Sorry, but we lost it, all the treasure.
No, you got attacked by Unversed.
Oh, well. That's too bad.
Who needs it?
It was literally the whole point in what you were doing.
Or doubloons or something, anyways.
We could just put what we treasure in there instead, if you wanna.
Yeah, that's perfect. Instead of filling it up with jewels and gold and stuff, we'll put in what's truly special to us, the real riches.
That's super sappy, but I approve.
What are you putting in, Ben?
I don't know. How about this?
No, don't do that. Tara gave you that. You'll never see it again.
One of my best friends gave
I mean, I understand the sentiment, but if I gave somebody
like
something like that,
huh?
And they... Yeah, exactly.
Something that special?
Exactly!
Yep. I don't need it if I've got Tara and Aqua. our best memories are still ahead.
I guess, but if I gave somebody something then, that important, they're like, oh yeah, I left it in another world. I'd be like, you motherfucker, you better go back and get that shit. My great-great-great-great-grandmammy gave me that.
Okay, it's a deal. Oh, wait, Tink.
Nope, nope. Mickey needs that.
I'm pretty sure that belongs to a friend of mine. Do you think maybe I could hang on to it?
Now, Tink!
Thank you.
That's right. Okay, so remember how when we were playing as Terra and he left this world and he was like, that shooting star, is that Ven?
He's gone.
Look, the light!
Well, this is why. I forgot that the star shard that when he leaves this world, it's because
the
star shard takes him.
No matter where that light takes him, Ven'll always have friends waiting to meet him.
Good God. That would make somebody sick riding around like that. Ugh, pixie petal. I don't even know why they give us that bullshit. Just to, what, fill out their Keyblade quota or something? Yeah, just throw a random bullshit one in there that no one's ever gonna use. Just so we can reach a certain number. Alright then. Now, I do believe... See, I'm pretty sure it's the case for all three
Gorge.
Characters.
The king must be pretty far away by
now. Oh, look,
now.
Donald and Goofy. Oh, yeah. Okay, so much like with Terra, the ending of Neverland automatically goes straight into more cutscenes. So, I'm gonna go ahead and, we'll watch them. Much like we did before. Boo-hoo. Well, at least the star shard came back to its master. Nope.
Nope, doesn't look like him.
Not even close.
Oh. Huh? Look, that feller's got the star shard the king borrowed.
King? Oh, you must be talking about Mickey. I saw him. What?
Yep.
Huh? Hey, take it easy.
Let's go.
They're like, come with us, we've got some questions for you. Where did you get that? Where were you on the night of Thursday the 14th? Hopefully this doesn't last too long, though. I do believe as soon as we leave this world, I'll be able to save and stop, so that's cool. Oh, actually, I could actually stop here if I wanted to. But I'm not going to, not yet. I want to save first, obviously. Or want to be at a part where I can save. Otherwise, what's the point? But this isn't a very long world, so we might as well just do it. Like I said, I need to push to the ending of this anyway, so... We'll end after we leave here. There's no save point in here anyways. Fuck. Alright, well, I have no choice then. Let's go. If I was going straight into another recording, I would, but I'm not, so... I want to be able to get to a stopping point.
We just got a clue as to where the king might be. Ventus.
Huh?
Atticus has told me much about...
This right here, by the way, is...
If I am not mistaken,
this scene...
ordered to return home.
Yeah.
Well, sir, I...
No matter.
Yeah.
Mickey has difficulty following directions, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jensen's like, it's okay. It'll be our little
Mickey
secret, Ventus, I understand. But anyways. This cutscene right here causes a continuity error in Kingdom Hearts 2. When Donald and Goofy get here with Sora, and they're like, Yen Sid lives here? Oh my! They should know that already, because look, they're here now. Unless they just got hit on the head one too many times.
We got sent flying into the light. I don't know where he went. He wasn't in the same world as the one where I found that.
He was at one point.
I thought.
But then Vanitas showed up.
He's been hurling himself from one world to the next. That explains why I could not discern his location.
You turned out, can't you?
Yes.
Yes, I can.
I'm sure since Vanitas got a hold of him, you can imagine where he's at. He said, such magic requires mumbling noises.
Mickey!
Also, notice how Mickey has the Starseeker Keyblade instead of the Kingdom Key D Keyblade? That's because that reverse Kingdom Key that he gets, from the Dark Realm
there
itself.
Is a dark and powerful force that is interesting.
Which he hasn't been to yet.
Magic.
Just tell us where the king is, Mr. Yen Sid, sir, and me and Donald will go right there and save him.
You guys would get your asses handed to you.
That may not be adequate.
Yeah, even Yen Sid but agrees.
I'm the captain of the king's royal knights.
I'll find him. I recognize the place we saw.
And you don't will come with you.
No, I owe him.
Oh, that pissed me off when I first played this. I was so excited. I was like, yay, Donald and Goofy are gonna join me for a boss battle. And then Ven's like, nah, I got this. It's cool. I'll go by myself. And I was like, shut the fuck up, Ven. Let them help you. God damn it. You ruined it with your big mouth. You stupid fucker. Ugh. Aggravated the... Oh, we get these stupid-ass D-Links instead. Go fuck yourself, Square Enix. Pissed me the fuck off. God damn it. Hate that. Ugh, I wanted so badly for them to join me. Christ! Okay. Alright, I'm done. That'll be it for this episode. In the next episode, we'll go to the Badlands and see what's going on with good old Mickey. And then Ventus will learn the truth about his origins and go home to face Master Ericus. And then you've seen Terra's story, so you know what happens next. And then we'll do... Then we'll probably end up at the fucking Keyblade Graveyard. So, anyways... We're getting super close to the end of Ven's story, getting close to the beginning of Aqua's. I know that these episodes are going to start getting... there's going to be a lot of them this week, but it's just because we have to race to the finish. It's a race to the finish. Now, let's go, 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 go. Bang, bang, bang. For those of you that are keeping up, good lord, you're gods. Either you have a lot of free time, or you just really, really love Kingdom Hearts. Either way, thank you so much. You're fantastic. For those of you that are watching this way later, you're just as great as well. Anybody who watches this, you're all fantastic. I love you. Anyways, I'm rambling. So thank you all so much for watching. My name is Oversoul. This is Oversoul Gaming. You've been fantastic, and I will catch you possibly on another day. Definitely at another time, and likely in another video. Okay, goodbye.